What in American history sticks out most to you?
Well, during that time that I was in college, I was really more focused on what was happening, locally, what was happening on campus. The national news, President Reagan was elected to president for president. He was the president, and we had a lot going on with Reaganomics and all of that, but I didn't really get that involved. Going from the finishing high school in the 79 and then going into the 80s in college, there were lots of changes in fashion and music. So basically, things were happening around me, but I wasn't really involved. I just knew it was happening. And if I look back on it, I pretty much was oblivious to what was happening nationally during the time that I was in college because it didn't directly affect me at the time.
What made you choose Texas Southern?
Again, as I said before, I was born in Houston. My father was a senior pharmacy student, pharmacy major, and in he finished in 61. I was born in 61, and so that was real cool. And we lived in the neighborhood, lived across the street in the CUNY Homes, and then my grandmother lived around the corner on Alabama Street. So we were Texas Southern bred, and my cousins went to Texas Southern, and so I always wanted to come back to Houston after we left, and it just was a no-brainer for me why I chose TSU.
Okay, and what did you study?
I originally went to school for technology. It was computer science, and I spent 2 years, a year or so in computer science, and then I changed my major to business. While I was in a business major, I was going to change it to education, but that would have kept me in school too long. So I went ahead and finished up in the School of Business, business management and administration.
And what memories at Texas Southern stuck out to you the most?
I really like the closeness of the student body. The student body, we were really close. We were like a family. We had a lot of team. We had a lot of spirit for our teams, our whatever sport, basketball, football, baseball. We just stuck together, and some of those relationships that I built during that time grew, and we are still friends with my college roommates. During that time, I was a resident assistant. We had the program council had always had programs for us because of different students from different places, Chicago, Louisiana. We had large groups of students from Houston, and I came from Tulsa, Oklahoma, and so there was a group of us from Tulsa. So individuals who came from different places sort of hung together and brought together their clubs, and then we intermingled with other individuals. So that those social networking relationships, which I still have those are my greatest memories. I was at the time, I was not the best student. My grades reflect that, but it built me as a person as far as working on teams, built my character, and of course, my networking abilities, and then supporting. I wasn't involved in the political arena, but I was involved in supporting you know, the HBCUs. I was a supporting Texas Southern, but I was also a supporter of Prairie View, and Southern and Grambling, that whole SWAT conglomerate of individuals.
Okay, and my last question to you is, do you think HBCUs are important? Why or why not?
I do think they're important. Now, I'm 55 years old, and anytime I meet other individuals who have attended and graduated from HBCUs, doing great things in the community. I think because of that, going to an HBCU, I'm involved, I'm aware of social action because of being with the African-American community. Not only African-American, we had a large Hispanic population at Texas Southern. We had a large international population at Texas Southern. And so I think that there's a place there where we can come together and uplift one another, then go out, because I did attend a non-HBCU and receive my teaching, went on and received a teaching degree, and went on and received my master's from a non-HBCU. It was the background, it was the building, me as a student and as a person. So I think it has its significance there, because it's a cultural thing. They teach you how to deal within your culture and without your culture. So because of that, I was able to be successful in a non-HBCU.
All right. Thank you so much for your time.
All right.